I'm motivated by fear. Fear of fear. I hate being scared to do something. It's very simple. This is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it. Yeah. Period. You can't be scared to die for the truth. The truth is the only thing that's ever going to be constant. And you can't fear what might happen to you if you were to tell the truth. Because what happens to you if you don't tell the truth is worse than telling the truth will ever be.
The first step before anybody else in the world believes it is you have to believe it. There's no reason to have a plan B because it distracts from plan A.
And I think psychologically, the advantage that gives me over a lot of people that have been in competition with in different situations is it's difficult to take the first step when you look how big the task is. The task is never huge to me. It's always one brick. I believe, and I learned very young, that you don't try to build a wall. You don't set out to build a wall. You don't say, I'm going to build the biggest, baddest, greatest wall that's ever been built. You don't start there. You say, I'm going to lay this brick as perfectly as a brick can be laid. There will not be one brick on the face of the earth that's going to be laid better than this brick that I'm going to lay in this next 10 minutes. Yeah. And you do that every single day.
And soon you have a
wall.
I've never really viewed myself as particularly talented. Where I excel is ridiculous, sickening work ethic. You know, while the other guy's sleeping, I'm working. While the other guy's eating, I'm working.
The separation of talent and skill is one of the greatest misunderstood concepts for people who are trying to excel, who have dreams, that want to do things. Talent you have naturally. Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of beating on your craft.
I always knew that I could work hard enough. There wasn't an issue with discipline, or there wasn't an issue with the ability to sacrifice or the willingness to sacrifice.
There's no easy way around it. No matter how talented you are, your talent is going to fail you if you're not skilled. Mm-hmm. You know, if you don't study, if you don't work really hard and dedicate yourself to being better every single day.
Mm-hmm. This one year, my father had his shop, and he decided for whatever reason that he wanted a new wall on the front of his shop. So he tore down probably about 16 feet high and probably about 30 feet long. He just completely tore the wall down, and my brother and I had to dig a 6-foot hole.
We for the foundation.
For the foundation. Right. We would mix in the concrete by hand. Yeah. A year and a half. We were building this wall for a year and a half. Every day after school, we would come and mix in concrete, put it in the hole, doing it. Yeah. And it was just myself and my little brother. And I remember standing back, looking at that wall, saying, there's going to be a hole here forever. A year and a half later, we laid the final brick. Yeah. And my father stood back with my brother and I, and I know he planned this. He says he didn't, but I know he had been planning this and writing this for his for the past 2 years. But we stood back, we looked at the wall, and he looked at me and my brother and said, don't y'all never tell me that you can't do something. And walked into the shop. As a child, my parents always told me, you could be whatever you want to be, you could do whatever you want to do. And you know, that office, that position, the highest office on the face of the earth, it was something I heard my parents saying it, but I didn't totally believe it. Yet I went out in the world and I carried myself and I held my head high and I stood there and I looked people in their eyes and I talked to people as if I was deserving of everything that this planet has to offer. I really want to say to children out there and to people who are watching, Confucius said one time, he who says he can and he who says he can't are both usually right.